Considering a proposal to require immigration status checks when workers get a new job, except for one industry.
And this industry is perhaps the most likely to hire undocumented immigrants. NBC2's Zach Barrett is here to explain the E-Verify loophole.
Well, right now, employers can choose to check a new hire's immigration status. But this bill would force everyone to use it, except if you run a farm in Florida.
Every piece of fruit that we pick in Florida, whether it's an orange, a grapefruit, a tomato, a bell pepper, a watermelon, is all picked by human hands. We need labor to do that.
Which is why this new bill would require all businesses to use E-Verify to check immigration status, except for farmers.
There's still a substantial number of workers who are here without legal documentation.
Farmer and former state rep Matt Caldwell supports the idea, saying farm owners he knows already steer clear of undocumented workers.
Agriculture is a big business, and folks don't want to fool around with the possibility of having illegal labor on their farm.
Fritz Rocha, the director of agribusiness at FGCU, says if farm workers were checked in the E-Verify system, farm owners could suffer, and so could you.
Imposing E-Verify could substantially hurt a number of agricultural operations, because then these people would no longer be eligible, or they would be deported. If we were to offshore all our vegetable products, I can see the price going up.
Farm owners can apply for a temporary work visa that allows farmers to come over legally. Rocha says if E-Verify was required for every business, it would hit our area hard.
Immokalee, Clewiston, Arcadia, Naples, Fort Myers, all would be seriously impacted if we didn't have this workforce to pick our crops.
Caldwell says land has become so expensive in Florida that some farmers are moving away from those labor-intensive produce farms and have begun farming things like hay and cattle. Live in the studio, Zach Barrett, NBC2.